r/AskReddit. Etymologists of Reddit, what is the coolest origin of a word? Etymologist of Reddit, what's your best bug fact? Etymology. Dashboard. The dashboard is a board on the front of a horse carriage meant to keep mud from kicking up on the passengers when the horse dashes. And over time it came to mean the front part of anything. Even a computer interface is sometimes called a dashboard. The etymology of tawdry is a real ride. There was a 7th century Anglo-Saxon saint named Athelthryth. Now. Nobody. Not even 7th century Anglo-Saxons. Wants to go around trying to pronounce that dense forest of s. So she was commonly known as Street. Ethelreader. And later. Linguistically lazier people called her Street. Audrey. Street. Audrey was the patron saint of a town called Ely. And the folks of Ely held a fair every year in her name. One of the primary products on offer at these fairs was lace. Street. Audrey's lace was said a few too many times. And got slurred down to tawdry lace. Over time. The lace fell out of favor. It was mainly made by peasant women. And thus viewed as cheap. And the Puritans looked down on lace garments of any kind as ostentatious. Tawdry then began to be used to describe other things that were cheap and ostentatious. And the modern definition of the word was born. TLDR. Tawdry comes from the fact that Athelthryth is really hard to pronounce. Etymology. Nightmare. The mare part of the word nightmare comes from Germanic folklore, in which a mare is an evil female spirit or goblin that sits upon a sleeper's chest, suffocating them and/or giving them bad dreams. So basically the word comes from a description of sleep paralysis. Etymology. Honeybees have to make about 10 million trips to collect enough nectar for production of 1 pound of honey. Etymology. The English word silly has meant a ton of different things since it was first used. The word's considerable sense development moved from happy to blessed to pious. To innocent. C. 1200. To harmless. To pitiable. Late 13 C. Weak. C. 1300. To feeble in mind. Lacking in reason. Foolish. 1570s. Further tendency towards stunned. Dazed as by a blow. 1886. Knocked silly. Etc. I don't know much about bugs besides Drosophila though. The word apron was originally napron. But when people said an apron it got gradually transformed into an apron. I have no bug facts. Etymology. Nimrod was originally a compliment referring to one's hunting skills, Nimrod being a biblical figure known for his ability to hunt. But the definition changed because people didn't understand Bugs Bunny was calling Elmer Fudd a Nimrod sarcastically. Etymology. Earwigs have wings. And can fly. Etymology. Cliché. Is derived from the sound of dapping ink on typeface. Anyone who has used an ink roller will understand the sound of sticky ink, so it's the repeated sound of regularly and therefore overused piece of type. Etymology. Australia has had a massive problem with the buildup of animal waste following the introduction of cattle. Native dung beetles only worked with hard dry dung of marsupials and wouldn't touch the cowpats of imported cows. Etymology. Calcium. Calculator. Calculate. Calculus. Abacus all share an origin in the word calx. Latin for stone. The word entomology is from the Greek entomon. Meaning insect. Which is itself the neuter form of entomos. Meaning segmented. Malaria. Malaria is an infectious disease characterized by chills and fever and caused by the bite of an infected Anopheles mosquito. This word comes from the medieval Italian mal, bad, and aria, air. Describing the miasma from the swamps around Rome. This bad air was believed to be the cause of the fever that often developed in those who spent time around the swamps. In fact, the illness, now known as malaria, was due to certain protozoans present in the mosquitoes that bred around these swamps, and which caused recurring feverish symptoms in those they bit. Etymology. Shibboleth was a Hebrew word for a part of a plant. But at one point it was used to determine whether someone belonged to one cultural group or another because the groups pronounced the word differently. Now, it refers to words and phrases like those that out someone as part of a particular group whether it's by pronunciation or understanding. For example, Get a native German speaker to say squirrel and they almost definitely won't be able to. Etymology. Some wasps inject their eggs into a host and the host gets mind controlled to protect the developing babies. The interesting thing is that it's not the eggs that control the host but a virus that the wasp injects along with the eggs. Ampersand. And, used to be a letter in the English alphabet. It came after Z in the alphabet. In the alphabet song. After you finished with Z, kids would sing. Ampersand, which is where the name ampersand comes from. Ampersand basically means also and as itself. Juggernaut. The word is derived from Jagannath. Jagannath means lord of the world and is a deity worshipped in India. Orange. The word for the fruit came long before the word for the color. We just called things which were the color orange. Yellow, red. Additionally, William of Orange, William II of England, has nothing to do with either the color or the fruit. The word oxymoron. The word oxymoron itself, appropriately enough, is an oxymoron. The oxy part, the same as in words like oxygen, paroxysm and peroxide, comes from the Greek word for sharp or acrid. Oxys. The moron part, the same as in, well, moron, comes from the Greek word for dull. Moros. So an oxymoron is literally a sharp dull turn of phrase. I love the origin of berserk. It comes from Old Norse for bear shirt. Where Vikings would put on shirts made of the hide of skinned bears and I guess get possessed by the spirit of the bear and just go absolutely upper shit on whatever. The word queue, meaning a long stick used in billiards, comes from the French word queue, meaning tail. The English word queue also comes from the French word, the Latin word corda, from which queue ultimately derives. Also brought us English coda, but that comes via Italian instead of French. The word queue, meaning an indication that it's time for something to happen, or as a verb, to give such an indication, comes from the letter Q. It was written as an abbreviation for quando, Latin, when, on actors' partial copies of play scripts. To save on paper, your copy of the script wouldn't include every line, just the ones right before your lines, marked with Q. So you'd have to learn your cues to know when your line was coming. A little late to this thread but my favorite one isn't on here yet. Mortgage. Mort death. Gage pledge. Death pledge. Very fitting for a 30-year loan. Etymology. The word avocado comes from the Aztec word for testicle. That's literally the only one I can think of right now. Etymology. The largest insect on earth, the wheater, has a unique survival mechanism. When winter rolls around, they die. They physically die. There is no heartbeat or brain activity. And their brains rot. Nobody knows how they do it. But the moment the weather warms up and the frozen wheater thaw, even without their brains, their hearts restart. And they go on to breed before dying for real. Also, they hiss. Good luck with that. Etymology. You can kill cockroaches with plain isopropyl alcohol in a spray bottle. You don't need to buy those special bug sprays if you only need to kill them on the spot. Spray them. And don't stop. Because they will try to run away. But they'll die after a couple minutes. Try to catch them in a can. Spray the shit out if then with alcohol and they'll die. Works because they dry out and die. Never had to resort to a broom. Also, more environmentally safe and won't hurt your pets. Bad in English apparently comes from an old word for hermaphrodite. But what is also interesting is that Persian has the word bad, which means the exact same thing but developed independently, despite the fact that the languages are related. And funnily enough, comma better looks a lot like better. And it means better too. Newborn honeybees don't have hardened stingers because they haven't dried out enough. Also, their wings are still drying so they can't fly. This leads to a lot of fun in the lab because they can be pet and held. The word barbarian comes from an ancient Greek word referring to all non-Greek speakers, including Egyptians, Phoenicians, etc. This was because to the Greeks, all other languages sounded like people saying bar bar bar. This became the root for the word barbarous, which roughly means babble or gibberish. It was later adopted by the Romans to refer to any culture that did not practice Greek or Roman traditions, even though Latin speakers were technically classified as barbarians because they didn't speak Greek. Due to good old xenophobia, it eventually came to mean uncivilized. And from there it made its way through the centuries into Middle English. Luciferase. The enzyme responsible for fireflies glowing comes from the name Lucifer, which means light bearer. In Greek mythology, Hades had a giant three-headed dog named Cerberus that guarded the entrance to the land of the dead. Cerberus comes from an older Sanskrit word, Carabus, meaning spotted. So Hades, a literal Greek god, has a hellhound named Spot. Disclaimer. I am not an etymologist, and this is disputed. I still like it. Row. Good timing. I just learned this one today. Etymology of the word clue. The word clue originates with the myth of Theseus, who used a ball of yarn to find his way back out of the Minotaur's labyrinth. The Middle English word for a ball of yarn was clue, or clue. When the myth was popularized in England by Chaucer, people started using the word clue figuratively to mean a hint or guide to solving a problem. Reddit. Holy forking shirt balls. This blew up. I have so many internet points now. Obligatory thanks for the gold. Kind stranger. I don't know much etymology, but I have some basic entomology. Even though most people think termites are close to ants because of their appearance and social habits, they are actually way closer to cockroaches and have been considered part of the same order for a while now. The Indian Marathi word and the American Native Cherokee word for squirrel, salary, are by pure coincidence the same. NSFW entomology fact. Ever heard of Spanish fly? Well, it's actually a beetle. Specifically one belonging to a group known commonly as blister beetles. They secrete a substance known as cantharidin that does exactly what you think it does. This substance has also been used as an aphrodisiac. When consumed, it reacts the same way it would if you got some on your skin. Starting with the softest tissues, you end up with an itch that you can't scratch in your most delicate areas. It's also super easy to overdose on, leading to a rather unpleasant end. Sometimes horses will die as a result of blister beetles getting into their feed. There was an episode of Jeopardy recently where the final Jeopardy's subject was surnames. It had to do with a common Italian last name that is associated with speed and style. And it derives from the Latin word for iron. The answer was Ferrari. I thought that was kind of neat. Chinese characters have some pretty great pictorial roots, if that can be considered etymology. My personal favorite is Q3. It means to take Caesar Tang. The radical on the left represents an ear while the one on the right represents a hand, or a blade. I've been told. The radicals come together to show a picture of how one takes an ear in war as a prize to prove a kill. Also, I can't find any sources for it. But my old teacher told me as people pouring blood into a bowl to mix and drink together a la blood brothers. It means to benefit from something. English used to have a letter called thorn which kind of looked like the letter Y. It made a buzzing sound like in the. It's why you see signs like ye olde shop. It's pronounced the old shop, not ye old shop. Entomologist here. Some walking sticks copulate for over 70 days. Assassin. N. 1530s, in Anglo-Latin from mid 13C, via French and Italian. From Arabic hashishii and hashish users. Plural of hashishii. From the source of hashish, QV. A fanatical Ismaili Muslim sect of the mountains of Lebanon in the time of the Crusades. Under leadership of the old man of the mountains, translates Arabic Sheikh al-Jaibal. Name applied to Hassan ibn al-Sabah. They had a reputation for murdering opposing leaders after intoxicating themselves by eating hashish. The plural suffix in was mistaken in Europe for part of the word, compare Bedouin. Middle English had the word as assace, mid 14C. From Old French assassis. Assassis. Which is from the Arabic word. Sophomore. It means wise fool in ancient Greek. I also like. Comma hazard. Which meant the die in Arabic. Because gambling was considered risky. Comma trivia. Which meant three roads in Latin. Because patricians looked down upon such intersections with disdain. as being insignificant and full of commoners, comma candidate, which means white-robed, comma avocado, which in Nahuatl shared a definition with testicle, comma orchard, which in Greek meant testicle, comma testify, which is a cognate of testicle, comma porcelain, which means pig's vagina, comma vanilla, which means vagina, comma girl, which could once refer to either gender, comma toilet, which used to mean closet in French, and many, many more. While making stone sculptures, it was highly likely that the carver will make a mistake which cannot be undone, especially if he was not very skilled. To hide their mistakes, they used to apply wax and shape it accordingly. The sculpture with wax was seen as impure and with flaws representing dishonesty of the carver. The Spanish for wax is cera. Hence the sculptures without wax were called sincera in Spanish. From there came the word sincere, that is, without any flaw or pure, is archaic meaning and now meaning honest. The word vaccine comes from the Latin word vaccinus, which means of the cow. This is because the guy that first popularized the treatment in turn prevented smallpox in children by exposing them to material from a cowpox blister, a milder form of smallpox. Etymology. Tycoon is the anglicization of taken, an archaic Japanese term of respect derived from Chinese I Ching, which once referred to an independent ruler who did not have an imperial lineage. Its literal meaning is great lord, prince or supreme commander. In the Edo period, this word was used as a diplomatic title designating the shogun of Japan in relations with foreign countries, as an attempt to convey that the shogun was more important than the Japanese emperor. In English, it generally refers to a wealthy businessman magnate. Etymology. The Japanese giant hornet, Vespa mandarinia japonica, can inject a venom that can cause renal failure and even death in humans. Hornets and other bees attribute to around 30-40 deaths a year in Japan. Not only that, but they release a pheromone that can signal hive mates that you are a target. Oh, and they can fly up to 50 miles a day. So run if you want. But they inevitably will track you down. Odonate, damselflies and dragonflies. Larvae are aquatic and capture their prey using an extensible mask from modified mouthparts. Video in action. What they look like partially extended in one species. What they look like folded into the face. Also, dragonfly larvae can propel themselves and their environment by shooting water out of their rectum. They usually move water in and out of the area because that's where their gills are located. But they can expel the water quickly to avoid predators. Pumpernickel comes from the German words pumpern, to break wind, and nickel, goblin. Apparently due to its indigestibility, their bread is so coarse it would make the devil break wind. Ill-baked. And as black as a coal. For they never sift their flour. The people of the country call it pumpernickel, the grand tour. Or, a journey through the Netherlands, Germany, Italy, and France by Thomas Nugent. II. Page 80. The word bear in many languages in Europe, including English, just means brown thing. There used to be a proper name for bear, but it was taboo because saying it was believed to summon a bear, who would then kill everyone. It was so taboo it was eventually forgotten and the euphemism, brown thing, became the name. Ancient people were scared pissless by bears. Edit. The Arctic draws its root from Arctus, Greek for bear. So it's the land of bears. The Antarctic is thus the land without bears. Roger is just the modern English equivalent of the Old English and Old Norse name Hrothgar. Edit. Additionally, Hrothgar means famous spear, and is the name of the Danish king in the medieval epic poem Beowulf. Etymology. Melon not particularly interesting in itself. It came from ancient Greek, through Latin, to Old French, before finding its way to English. All along the way it referred to various goods. However, and this is the interesting bit, melons was slang for boobs in Greek, and it retained this slang definition as well as its real definition all the way to English. Usually in etymology you keep one definition or the other, and never both. Which makes it really interesting. Also boobies. Etymology. The Japanese red bug. In addition to having the most creative bug name ever, is one of the few known non-eusocial, eusocial, colony bugs like ants, bees, termites, insect to take care of its young after they hatch. The word quintessential has one of my favorite etymologies. You can break it down into quint and essential. Quint as in five. Essential as in essence. Or element. To be quintessential is to be the fifth element of something. To be the thing's spirit. If you want to get nothing in return, you can like and join my Discord. There is a link in the description.